All right, good evening everyone. Chalo, we'll go ahead and have our Maharevision part 3 today. In Maharevision part 3, today after ITC, we are going to discuss with payments of taxes. Sir, payment of taxes? Baba, whenever a person goes and takes online registration on the eWay, on the GST portal, Baba, three accounts will be opened for him. What are the three accounts opened for him? E-liability ledger, E-credit ledger, E-cash ledger. E-liability ledger, there'll be a debit. What are the things that are debited in E-liability ledger? Baba, whatever is your self-assessed tax, whatever amount is raised in the demand order, whatever amount is as a result of mismatching, sir, which is not happening now, and sir, any interest which may accrue from time to time. Sir, how do I go ahead and make that payment? Baba, that amount will be paid through e-credit ledger and then through e-cash ledger. Sir, if I have to go ahead and pay, what should I pay first? Baba, always remember, what do you make the payment first? Manner of discharge is self-assessed tax liabilities and dues which are relating to the previous tax period. Baba, any amount which is relating to current tax period. Then Baba, all the other amounts which are due, including the demand and demand order ka dues. Sir, if I notice any discrepancies, how do I go ahead and tell the officer? Baba, don't call. You have to file which form? PMT04. Next, sir, e-credit ledger, rule number 86. Rule number 86 says, what will be credited to your e-credit ledger? Whatever is your self-assessed tax liability, sir, any other self-assessed input tax credit. Baba, self-assessed, whatever input tax credit is there, that will be credited to your e-credit ledger. What will be debited, Baba? Whatever amount you use towards making payment of your output tax liability. Sir, my input tax ka liability, the reverse charge ka liability is my input tax liability, which I can't pay using my input tax credit. Input tax credit can be used only for output tax liability. Sir, how do I go ahead and make the payment? The manner of utilization, first, IGST should be used for IGST, then IGST should be used for CGST or SGST in any manner, any proportion. Then Baba, IGST should be exhausted, then CGST will be used for CGST, CGST will be used for IGST, then SGST will be used for SGST, SGST should be used for IGST. In any condition, don't use CGST to SGST or SGST to CGST. Always for payment of IGST, CGST should be used, then SGST should be used. Sir, if there is any balance in the e-credit ledger, can I go ahead and take the refund? Yes, Baba, you can take refund, but only in two situations. All other situations, in e-credit ledger, you don't get the refund. There are only two situations. Number one is zero rated supply ka refund. Number two is inverted tax pattern. What is inverted tax pattern? When your output tax liability is lower than your input tax credit ka tax rate. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, e-cash ledger, rule number 87. Sir, rule number 87, e-cash ledger. I'll first have to deposit an amount in e-cash ledger. How do I make a deposit, everyone? Taxable person first have to go online and create a challan. Challan has to be created in PMT06. Challan shall be valid for 15 days. You will have to go ahead and Baba, generate a challan. Once you generate a challan, CPN is generated. Once CPN is generated, you will have to go ahead and make the payment. Payment can be made either through net banking, NEFT, RTGS, over the counter, which is maximum 10,000. Sir, 10,000 per challan per tax period. Cash means, Baba, over the counter can be made in cash, check or DD. Right, everyone? OIDR will make payment by using international money transfer. Once you make the payment, amount will be deposited to the government account. CPIN will become SIN. CPIN is what? Common Portal Identification Number. SIN is what? Challan Identification Number. And the amount will be credited to your e-cash ledger. Baba, whatever you deposit, if you deposit tax, tax will come to you. If you deposit interest, interest will come. If you deposit late fee will be deposited. Whatever amount you pay will be deposited. Basically, it will be created in your e-cash ledger. Sir, e-cash ledger can be used for making payment of anything. Yes, Baba, whatever you deposit, you can use for payment of that output tax liability. Sir, TDS liability, TCS liability, RCM liability, which is your input tax liability, and composition tax. always has to be paid by using your cash ledger. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, if any balance in there in the e-cash ledger, if any balance is there, can I take a refund? Yes, Baba, you can go ahead and take a refund of that. Can I go ahead, everyone? Always remember one thing. Restriction of over-the-counter 10,000 is not applicable whenever government department or person notified by commissioner is making the payment, or PO or other officer is depositing who has recovered it during recovery of dues, or PO or other officer authorized for the amount collected during investigation. Always remember one more thing. Major heads are IGST, CGST, SGST, SES and UTGST. Minor heads, every major will have 5 minor. Minor means what? Tax, interest, penalty, fees or any other amount. Sir, cross utilization of fund across major to minor or minors may also, it is not possible. Sir, how will a unregistered person make the payment? Unregistered person will make the payment on the basis of temporary identification number. Sir, there is something called a EFPB, Electronic Focal Point Branch. It is a branch of authorized bank which is authorized to collect GST. Every bank which is authorized has to appoint one branch as EFPB on pan India basis. Here we are done with the chapter of payment of taxes. One small point over here, Baba, section number 50 is also there. 49 spoke about payment of taxes. Read with rule number 85, 86, 87. 85 is e-liability, 86 is e-credit, 87 is e-cash ledger. Baba, section number 50 told about interest on delayed payment. Any delayed payment you have to pay along with interest at the rate of 18%. Sir, if I have claimed excess credit, Baba, you have taken excess credit or you have unduly used credit, then Baba, you will have to refund, you will have to pay back along with interest at the rate of 24% per annum. The next discussion is on TDS now. Everyone, the next discussion is on TDS. Baba, TDS under section number 51. TDS was effective from 1/10/2018. Basically, if there is a supplier who supplies to government department. Baba, government department, I have told Modi's department. Wherever the supply value is greater than 2.5 lakh, excluding what? Tax. Excluding tax. So Baba, government department first has to take compulsory registration, which can be TAN based or PAN based. It has to take a separate registration and then it will deduct TDS only on the value of supply. It will not go ahead and deduct on tax amount, GST. Now, once it deducts the remaining amount, it will go ahead and remit to the supplier. But the tax amount which is deducted, the government department has to go ahead and make the payment to the government by a challan, and then it has to file one TDS ka return, which is GSTR 7, by 10th of the next month. Sir, issue a TDS certificate in GSTR 7A within 5 days of creating or depositing the TDS to the government. Sir, if did not go ahead and submit or failure to issue TDS certificate, late fee will be rupees 100 per day, subject to a maximum of 5,000. Always remember, same amount is payable under SGST Act also. Sir, if I fail to deduct, Baba, if the government department fails to deduct, then the recovery proceedings can start. Baba, demand will come basically under section number 73 and 74. Always remember, there can also be a penalty, and penalty can be 10,000 or TDS amount, whichever is higher. Basically, they will be liable to pay tax, interest and penalty. Penalty is 10,000 or 10,000 or TDS amount, whichever is higher. Sir, deduction, when do I have to deduct? Baba, you have to deduct on payment or crediting, whichever is earlier, and hence TDS is also on advances. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, which are the government department who has to do TDS? Government department, Baba, there are 4 people who has to do. Now, 3 are specified: Department of Central Government, State Government, Local Authority, or the last one is Governmental Agency. And Baba, 4th one which is there are notified people. Government has gone ahead and issued a notification. Who are the notified people? Authority, board or other body which is set up by the Act of Parliament or State Legislature or establishment of the government, and in both of them the equity and control greater than 51% is of the government, or it is a society which is established by the government and which is registered under the Societies Act, sir, or it is a PSU. Baba, in all these are the people who are notified, and then Baba, no TDS if all of them, basically डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, लोकल अथॉरिटी और नो 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 थर्ड वन पर्सन गवर्नमेंटल एजेंसीज और पर्सन नोटिफाइड आर सप्लाइंग गुड्स और सर्विस अमॉन्ग देमसेल्फ देन टीडीएस इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड। बाबा गवर्नमेंट डिपार्टमेंट में वन मोर डिपार्टमेंट हैज बीन एक्सक्लूडेड विच इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ डिफेंस। कैन आई गो अहेड एवरीवन? सर व्हाट आर द केसेस व्हेन TDS is not required? TDS is not required when supplier and place of supply is in one state and recipient is in the other state. I hope you guys remember. The second one was when transactions are out of scope. Number three, when transactions are nil rated, wholly exempted or non-taxable. Fourth one, when transaction where tax is payable under RCM, if government is only going to pay the whole amount under RCM, there is no requirement to do TDS. Next one, if payment is made to an unregistered supplier because he will not get the credit, you should not deduct TDS. And Baba, no TDS when payment relates to an invoice which was issued before 1/10/2018 because the TDS ka provisions were only effective from 1/10/2018. Sir, no TDS on advances before 1/10/2018 but invoice is on or after to the extent of advance before 1/10/2018. Sir, one more thing. Once this person, when the Modi ji ka department goes ahead and pays the tax, government department pays the tax, it will be made available to the supplier. It will be made available to the deductee. Deductee will have to validate and only this amount will be credited to his e-cash ledger. Always remember, TDS amount is credited to your e-cash ledger. Here we are done with the TDS ka discussion. Baba, one small thing we missed. We missed that TDS should be deducted 1% under CGST, 1% under SGST and IGST mein it is 2%. Can I go ahead everyone? And also, Baba, if the contract value, you will not have to see individual invoice. You will have to see the total contract value. If the total contract value is more than 2.5, on individual invoices you have to deduct. Are we clear? For an example, invoice is given 20,000, but the total contract value is more than 2.5, then on the all the invoices, TDS has to be deducted. Here we are done with our discussion on TDS. Let's go ahead and have our discussion now on TCS. Baba, TCS section number 52. Section number 52 is effective from 1/10/2018. Baba, basically, there'll be a supplier, there'll be an e-commerce operator, and there'll be a person who wants to buy something. So supposingly this person went online, this person who was the buyer went online to Flipkart and placed an order. Flipkart will forward the order to the supplier. Supplier will go ahead, pack and supply. Now supplier will go ahead and raise an invoice on the this customer and customer will make the payment to Flipkart. When Flipkart is making the payment or the e-commerce operator is making the payment, Flipkart should deduct 0.5% CGST and 0.5% SGST or 1% IGST and the same should be remitted to the government. But when it is deducting TCS, how will it go ahead and make the payment to the government? For that, the e-commerce has to take a compulsory registration and the PAN-based, and the registration is PAN-based. Sir, no TCS if amount is directly received by the supplier. Basically, only when the payment goes through the e-commerce, e-commerce is liable to deduct TCS. Baba, it will deduct TCS only after taking TCS ka registration, which was a compulsory registration. It will pay the TCS by filing its monthly return, which is GSTR 8, by 10th of the next month. And then it will be made available to the supplier. Supplier will go ahead and validate and the amount will be credited to the e-cash ledger of the supplier. Sir, how will it come to the e-cash ledger of the supplier? For that, the supplier also has to take a compulsory registration. Can I go ahead, everyone? Baba, one thing you have to remember, the e-commerce operator will always deduct TCS on net turnover supplier wise. Whatever the supplier has supplied in this month minus the returns which have come, whatever is the remaining amount. So for an example, supplier supplied 10 lakh, returns have come 2 lakh, TCS will be done only on 8 lakh. Sir, can the supplier also keep his goods in the godown of the e-commerce operator? Yes, but then the supplier has to deduct this place as the additional place of business. Sir, What is the difference between basically TDS and TCS? Baba, TDS ka case mein, who is doing? Recipient used to deduct and pay to the गवर्नमेंट। टीसीएस का केस में ई कॉमर्स विल डिडक्ट एंड पेड टू द गवर्नमेंट। टीडीएस का केस में टीडीएस ऑब्लिगेशन वॉज ओनली ऑन नोटिफाइड सप्लायर, नोटिफाइड रिसिपियंट। ई कॉमर्स का केस में TCS is to be done by every e-commerce who receives the payment on behalf of the supplier. Sir, TDS is only when the contract value is greater than 2.5. TCS, there is no value limit. TCS has to be done irrespective of any value when the payment is received by the e-commerce operator. TCS, TDS deductor files which return? GSTR 7, TCS wala file GSTR 8. Sir, e-commerce operator, is it required to take registration in all the state? Yes, Baba, rule number 12, you'll have to see. Rule number 12 told that a TDS deductor has to take registration in all the state. Sir, how will I take registration? I don't have premises in all the state. But what you can do is when you are filing your GST REG 7, then Baba, part A mein you can mention the state where you want the registration, part B may just mention the head office ka address. I hope you guys remember that. Next, sir, e-commerce operator, when is no TDS TCS required? TCS is not required when the transactions are out of scope. Secondly, when the transactions on which tax is payable under RCM. Third, transaction is nil rated, wholly exempt or non-taxable. Sir, where the supplier who is supplying through e-commerce, Baba Swiggy, you remember this Mama Momo wala was there. So whenever the supplier who is supplying is unregistered means supplier of service was not required to take registration up to 20 lakh or 10 lakh. Sir, no TCS for services which are covered under 9.5, housekeeping, accommodation and transportation. Sir, supposingly there is a rectification which is noticed by the e-commerce operator later. Baba, whatever return is filing in that later month, he can go ahead and make that correction subject to interest at the rate of 18%. Sir, what is the maximum time limit to rectify? September month ka return of next year or annual return ka actual date, whichever is earlier. Sir, non-collection or omission will attract always a penalty under section number 122. Sir, do the annual return also have to be filed by the e-commerce operator? Yes, GSTR 9B has to be filed, which is to be filed by 31st of December. Sir, e-commerce will file GSTR 8. His GSTR 8 will be matched with my GSTR 1. And if there is any discrepancy, that will be communicated to both of us. Yes or no? We will have to rectify in the same month. Otherwise, it will be added to the output tax liability in the succeeding month with interest at the rate of 18% from the due date of payment till the due date of from the due date when you had to make the payment to the date of payment. Are we clear, everyone? One more thing which is there, Baba, if the officer greater than deputy commissioner wants to know any information about the e-commerce operator, they can go ahead and issue a notice and tell the e-commerce, you will have to give information to us about the supplies of goods, services or both affected through it and details of the stock maintained by the e-commerce operator. And sir, if e-commerce operator replies within 15 working days, no problem. Otherwise, there is a penalty of 25,000. Here we are done with TCS under section number 52. All right, everyone, we are done with TCS now. Let's go ahead and have the next one, which is returns. Baba, once you make the payment, you will have to go ahead and file your returns. Baba, returns I started with like this, that once a person starts business, after he becomes liable. Once he becomes liable, he should go ahead and apply within 30 days. If he goes ahead and applies within 30 days and the registration is granted, registration shall be valid from the date of grant, the date of becoming liable, and between the date of becoming liable to the date of grant, whatever he has supplied, he has to go ahead and issue a revised tax invoice. Now, after he is granted registration, he has to file first return, the first love which was there, the first return, yes or no, where he has to disclose all the details of the revised tax invoices which he has issued. After the first return is filed, Baba, then regular returns will start. Regular returns which were there, everyone, section number 37 told GSTR 1, which was outward supplies ka detail, which had to be filed by 10th, yes or no. And Baba, then Baba, it will go in GSTR 2A, auto-populated in the recipient. Baba, recipient will have to go ahead and file section number 38 told GSTR 2 by 15. Baba, once it files, it will come back to the supplier in GSTR 1A. I also told you GSTR 2 and 1A is not applicable for your exam. And then Baba, it will go in GSTR 3, which is the, you have to file GSTR 3, which is your monthly return. By what date, everyone? 20th. However, now since GSTR 3 is not going, what is going everyone? GSTR 3B. Baba, one more amendment which is there, which is telling that GSTR 3B which is furnished will only be treated as your return which was to be furnished under section number 39(1). It means you don't have to file GSTR 3 now. GSTR 3B which was furnished by you only will be treated as your GSTR 3. Can I go ahead everyone? Monthly return. Sir, then I'll keep filing 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. At the year end, you have to file your annual return. Baba, now annual return has been made optional for people whose turnover is up to 2 crore. Yes or no? But if your turnover crosses 2 crore, then you are required to file annual return under section number 44 along with Baba, which is the form? GSTR 9, which is to be filed along with audited financial statement and a reconciliation statement in GSTR 9C. Sir, then Baba, I kept on doing my business. One day I thought I'll close my business. If you close your business, then the cancellation proceedings will start section number 29. Yes or no? Cancellation proceeding. During this period, your registration will be suspended. Once the cancellation order comes, from the date of cancellation or the cancellation order, whichever is later, you will have to go ahead and file within 3 months final return, which is under section number 45. Sir, in my final return, I'll have to tell whatever I am liable to pay as per section number 29(5). Can I go ahead, everyone? And Baba, final return is GSTR 10, which is to be filed within 3 months of your date of cancellation or cancellation order, whichever is later. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, registered person, if he is a composition dealer or paying tax under 2/2019, he has to go ahead, make quarterly payment and file an intimation in GST CMP 08. And Baba, annually, Baba, every quarterly he has to file what return, what intimation? CMP 08, CMP 08, CMP 08. Baba, year end pay, by 30th of April, he has to file GSTR 4, which is his monthly return, quarterly return now made annual. Sir, he also has to file, composition dealer also has to file annual return, which is in GSTR 9A. Sir, NRTP has to file what return? GSTR 5. Sir, by what date? Within 20 days of the end of the month or within 7 days after the expiry of the validity, whichever is earlier. Sir, ISD also has to file a return, which is GSTR 6, after 10th, before 13th. Sir, UIN holder also has to file a return, which is which return? GSTR 11, which is basically the statement of his inward supplies so that he can claim the refund on those supplies. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, OIDR also is there. He has to file a return, which is GSTR 5A by 20th of the succeeding month. Sir, section number 40. Baba, till now we learned section number 38, we told about outward supplies ka detail. 37, we told about outward supplies ka detail. 38 told about inward supplies ka detail. 39 was there monthly returns. 40 was the first love. 41 which was there, Baba, provisional ITC can be taken. 42 and 43 was relating to matching, mismatching, not required. 44 which was there was your annual return. 45 which was there was your bye-bye final return. Correct everyone? 46 which is there, it is telling if you don't go ahead and submit your return, you will get a notice within how many days? 15 days. Baba, notice in GSTR 3A to furnish your return within 15 days. If you don't go ahead and make the file your return, then best judgment will be done. Can I go ahead everyone? Baba, then section number 47 told late fee has to be paid on late submission of your return. Yes or no? Monthly return, if it is late submitted, then 100 rupees per day subject to a maximum of 5000, which is now brought down to 25 rupees subject to a maximum of 5000. Nil return may 10 rupees subject to a maximum of 5000. Sir, annual return may 100 rupees per day subject to a maximum of how much? 0.25% of the turnover in state or UT. Sir, GSTR 3B which is there. What is GSTR 3B? Baba, instead of filing GSTR 3, you were required to file GSTR 3B which is a summary return where you go ahead and say your sale, you go ahead and say your purchases, inward supplies, you go ahead and make the payment and you file your return. Sir, GSTR 1 which was there is now made quarterly for people with turnover less than 1.5 crore per annum. Now, let's go ahead and see section number 40. 8, which talks about GSTP. Now, GST practitioner, everyone here on the chart. If you remember, GST practitioner, first you'll have to see the eligibility. Baba, eligibility as basic eligibility. What do you mean by basic eligibility of a GST practitioner? Section number, everyone, 48 we are reading. Right, everyone, GST practitioner. Now, basic eligibility says that he should be a citizen of India. He should not be mental. Basically, he should be sound mind. Sir, he should not be an insolvent and he should not be convicted by a court. Then Baba, plus one additional, this all four qualification he has to be there. He should have this basic eligibility has to be there. What is the additional qualification? He should be a retired government officer who can be commercial tax department or CB, Baba, CBIC greater than or equal to 2 year, or sales tax return or tax return preparer with greater than how many years experience? 5 year, graduate, postgraduate, plus a CA, CS, ICWI. Any one qualification he should have. Basic, he should have all four, and any additional qualification. Can I go ahead, everyone? Sir, he will apply in GST PCT01 in GST.gov.in. Baba, registration will be given. Basically, he'll have to apply for registration as a GST practitioner, and a certificate will be issued to him in PCT02 that will be lifetime valid. Baba, in between, they have to pass the exam. The pass the examination is 2 years. However, in case of sales tax return preparer, earlier it was 18 months. Now it has been extended to 30 months. This exam is conducted by whom, everyone? NASIN. Now, what are the various functions of the GST practitioner? Functions are, they can go ahead and file return, which can be monthly return, quarterly return, annual return. They can make deposit on behalf of the person in his e-cash ledger. Sir, he can file refund claim. He can file application for amendment or cancellation of registration. He can furnish information in e-way bill. Sir, he can furnish details in ITC04, which is job worker challan. Sir, he can amend or cancel what? Enrollment. You remember enrollment under section number 35. Sir, he can also file intimation for switching to or fro from composition, basically intimation CMP02 and CMP04. Sir, if he is found guilty of any misconduct, then what will happen? Show cause notice will be issued in PCT04, and his Baba show cause notice will be issued in 03, and an order will be given cancelling his GST practitioner ka registration in PCT04. Sir, can he also surrender? Yes, Baba, he can surrender. For that, application will go in PCT06 and order will come in PCT07. Here we are done with our chapter of returns, in which we learned section number 37 to section number 48. I'll stop the Maha revision till here today, everyone. Bye.